that I should save. When Moses saw a burning bush, he came closer. He came closer to the burning bush.
And he deals with me.
God my talent of music. God said to me, now it's time to preach. And one day I stood in the pulpit. I said to my pastor, can I preach next week? And my pastor said, yes, my girl. I preached it, and I preached it. And I went to the college. I went to high school. When I got to my high school, the teachers in the high school were in the assembly, were busy reading Psalms 23 every day. And I was sitting there. God was telling something in me. And I went to the principal. Daddy, I used to call him Principal Daddy. Principal Daddy, the teachers are doing Psalm 23 every day. And it's tiring me. Something inside of me says, no, it is the whole Bible. Can I preach every morning? And the principal said, baby, are you sure? I said, yes, sir. I'm just tired of Psalm 23. I know that the Lord is our shepherd, but there is something more. There is much more in this book that can transform the students and make them something that God wants them to be. The principal says, when do you want to start? Tomorrow.
Tomorrow, I was up
and I was walking an hour to school. Generation of today, you can't even walk an hour to school. And in my school, not even a school bag. My kids say, Mama, don't tell us, please. Don't go away. Every time when I try to explain, Mama, don't go away. It was your life. I was holding a shop like Checkers. Checkers, yeah. As my school bag. And inside, there was, you know, there was those bins, dark ones, small. Being small, and that's one my mama knew, you take this one, even four spoons you're full. Can I come home and say, I'm hungry? That was my life, baby girl. That was my life. Sometimes my mama would make us a soft porridge, and we were five, and one of them would put a soft porridge in the container of ice cream. One must hold teaspoons, one must hold sugar, one must hold milk so that you do not sit under the tree and eat alone. You must wait for everybody. That was my life. But when I handed over God my life, little did I knew that from this musician, God said, now you can preach. And after I preached in the assembly, God said, you are faithful now. You can come into my field now. You can preach. And every time when I go to the pulpit, people will come to me and say, please don't try this preaching thing. It's not for you. Just sing. I'm just a musician. God said to me, you were faithful with music, and I'm giving you another gift. And you are faithful with this. You are faithful with this, I'll give you nations. Little did I know that one day I'll be standing in front of you preaching. I took my stuff and handed it over to God. I'm still asking you today. Oh, I think Moses was feeling so great. Imagine, he was just looking at Pharaoh. Pharaoh, God tells me, I must tell you, let my people go. And Pharaoh says, where are you going? He said, where are you king? Don't know me there. Imagine living in that supernatural life where God comes and shines through you. And they say, where is this boy? He's from Kenya. And it's like, oh, King, you don't know me. Repeat what he just said. Repeat. Because he was practicing, that he knew what was going to happen. I just said, let's give God a wide hand of praise. Life to Jesus. I'm about to finish, Pastor. if Moses had said no to God. He would have robbed his generation. He would have missed out on what God has for his life. God's assignment, God has an assignment for you. And he's only asking you to borrow him his life. Quickly, let's go to what the significance of the staff of Moses. The significance of the staff of Moses speaks of his identity. When somebody was holding a staff like this, like Moses, it was a significance of him being a shepherd. So the gifts and the talents that God has given you, it's something that the world will identify you with. If you hand it over to God, God will make it alive and take you out of Kenya to other nations. That's your identity. That is something that God will use it for his glory. And the staff speaks of his income. Wealth was tied to the livestock back then in the time of Moses. And I believe that it's still the same. When you have livestock, you are rich, even in our today's life. So it was his income. He was not going out there, he would not eat, he would not feed his family. Some of the gifts and the talents, you are a scientist, accountant, that's your identity, that's your stuff, that's something that will bring income in your life. So you need to be faithful and hand it over to God so that God can multiply it. In the medical field, God can touch the medic and multiply it. And you know, there's these doctors that we just love them. We just love them. You find that there are doctors on the same street, but one doctor is packed because he's treating people right. Or maybe he has given his stuff to the Lord and God is multiplying it. Are you hearing me? Are you following me? Right, it speaks of the influence. Whatever God gives you, he wants you to use it to influence the nation. It is not about you. The gifts that God has given you, he has not given it for you. He has given them to you for the people out there. What you have today here in Kenya, the gifts and the talents that you have, they are not to serve you. They are to serve this institution. They are to serve.
I want to see what I'm doing with the slave here. Sir, may you please sit down? Right. I said to sir, love is not complete until you receive it. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
Your neighbor, is your love in the wrong place or in the...
thing. I hate it. I also go to church. Why do I have to come to chapel? I hate it. So I will just go. Not because I love you, but because we are forced. So I'll just come to the church and I can't wait for them to finish. So we can just go. Am I talking to somebody here? Are you the one I'm talking to today? Who gave you breath? Who gave you life? And he's just asking you for 1 hour of chapel. I tell you, by the time you get out of this place, you will remember this moment. And some of you, you're going to transform lives through this moment. So, sir,